Well, more now on that breaking news. Almost all Australian Open players and officials in isolation in Melbourne have returned negative results.
Tennis Australia CEO Craig Tiley confident the Grand Slam event will go ahead on Monday with only 12 people waiting on their results. And for more, Nine tennis commentator Leighton Hewitt joins us in Melbourne. Leighton, just 72 hours to go. Are you confident the tournament will go ahead?
Yeah, no, I'm very confident. It was a very strange day out at Melbourne Park yesterday, though, when they postponed all the matches, the ATP Cup, but also the ATP events and also the WTA there. So the players just had to really go out there and fine-tune some of their practice sessions leading into, obviously, restarting again today.
It will go down, Leighton, I'm sure, as one of the most difficult Australian Opens logistically to put together. Are you confident that officials have got it, they can handle anything that can happen?
Yeah, absolutely. For me, Tennis Australia has done everything they've needed to. If we can pull this off, obviously in the middle of a pandemic, it's something that I know the players will look back on and be extremely proud that they made the effort to come down here and do the hard quarantine for 14 days. But to give themselves an opportunity, because I think as the tour goes on throughout the year, when we see what's happening over in Europe and also in the States, it's going to be very tough on the global stage to have tennis tournaments run. And for us to get that opportunity to actually showcase what we can do here in Australia in the middle of all this is pretty incredible, really.
Isn't
Jeez,
it?
It's been tough on the players, though, hasn't it? Like, isolation again. How are they going to go, do you think, getting back out there?
Yeah, the isolation just of yesterday wasn't that tough on the players, because quite a lot of these guys have come in, haven't played many matches, and then they've actually had to go back-to-back for the last two or three days. So for them to actually freshen up for a day probably wasn't the worst thing, because it was really the only players that were put in that position yesterday were the ones that were staying in that particular hotel where that one case came from. So the rest of them were out there actually practicing and striking a few yesterday and just trying to fine-tune. The tough part now is to try and get all these matches in over the next 3 days before the Australian Open starts. So it's going to be interesting to see some of the results over the next couple of days, because obviously the big picture, that's starting Monday with the Australian Open.
Leighton, I reckon it's fascinating. It's going to be fascinating and probably the most watched Australian Open tennis in a long time. Given we don't know how people are going to handle it, how players are going to handle the different build-ups, how they're going to handle the different conditions, the different conditioning. Who do you think is going to be the standout, apart from the obvious?
Yeah, well, it's really tough at the moment. I guess some of those guys that played in Adelaide, they got that exhibition match over there as well. So the likes of Novak, Rafa are obviously going to be up there as the favourites coming into this event. But the big thing is none of these guys have played five-set tennis or been able to prepare for how they usually would play five-set tennis. So I guess trying to find your way through those first two or three rounds is going to be awfully important. That's something those top four or five guys have been able to do so well throughout their careers. But, you know, it's probably the perfect time to try and get an upset on some of those big name players where they're not quite used to being in this position that they're going to be thrown into on Monday or Tuesday.
Yeah, definitely makes it a bit of a wild card, doesn't it? We'll see who's really mentally tough here. What about the Aussies, Ash Barty and Nick Kyrgios? We'd all like to see them get up. How are they going to go?
Yeah, well, I think most of the Aussies didn't have to do the quarantine, so it's certainly in their favour that they came down back and actually did a couple of weeks of hard quarantine back in November, December, and they've been able to train and have pretty much a normal pre-season in a lot of ways. They haven't been able to get the court time, though, at Melbourne Park, because those courts were blocked off for the quarantine players. So it's really been this week just sort of adjusting to the conditions and the pace of court at Melbourne Park. I think Nick, you know, for him, the last two matches that he's played is important. He hasn't played all year. So for him just to get his body going again and play those couple of matches, get the rust off him. And obviously he's got so many weapons out there as well. He's going to be awfully dangerous. But I think if he can pull up well after this week, you know, he's certainly a dangerous floater that none of the big names will want to play early next week.
He is certainly dangerous, Nick Kyrgios. I love watching him. I can't wait to see what he does. I think he's got a magnificent chance this year. And Leighton, given that you had a little bit of a disturbed
preparation, I'd like to see you return your surf cup.
I'm also ready for you. I'd like to get out there and I'd like to have take you on too at some point, Leighton. It'll be awesome. But best of luck in the commentary. It's going to be fabulous. We look forward to it next week.
Look forward to it. Thanks very much, Leighton.